Okay, good day to everyone. Welcome to our fifth year subject CE511, which is construction method and project management. I'm your professor, Dr. Apollo Pablo Yuzantua. I am a civil engineer, I am an electrical engineer, I am a mechanical engineer, production engineer in Japan, I am an industrial engineer and plumbing engineer. So I think I would be somewhat competent to discuss this topic. I also have practical experience in the field of construction, wherein I handled assistant general manager position. So let us go to the topic. So this topic is very much related to your course in engineering, whether you are civil engineering, mechanical engineering, or industrial engineering of this university. And also, not just our beloved students, this video could also be played and reviewed by our more than 700 subscribers and 41,000 viewers. Nationwide. So let us talk about the key players on the construction business. So engineering and business is always connected to each other. So one of the most important player is therefore the owner. The owner owns project upon completion of the construction. We will what? We will turn over the finished product to the owner, whether it is a private owner or public owner. Public owner meaning the project is for public use. For example, project by our mayor, project by our congressman, and public officials. So, very much important key player because the owner always have the budget to proceed with the starting of the construction. Okay? So, another important is, of course, us. We are the technical person competent to accomplish the project. We are architects, we are engineers, we are design professionals. And we are the one who will assess the owner in developing his conceptual plan into reality. We will transform those plan into actual. For example, when the owner is going to put up a commercial building, we engineers would like to accomplish the making, the construction of building by first surveying the field and putting up the columns, the footings, and the structure, and then beautifying the building. And then lastly, we will turn over, as we have just said before, we will turn over the finished product, the finished building to the owner upon the completion of the project. Okay, so next. We also deal with contractor because sometimes our technical persons like architects and engineers are just professionally involved with the project. Sometimes we are not involved in terms of financial aspect of the project. And because of that, if we don't have the capability to be involved financially on the construction of a project, therefore we need contractor to do that. So contractors, they are the type of businessmen who would risk money, who would risk capital in order to assume the financial flow that would support the construction. For example, we need the materials, we need raw materials, we need labor force, the contractor will do all those things, providing the engineers with helpers, with electricians, with welders. All those things could be provided smoothly by the contractor because he is the one competent on making those processes work smoothly and in hand, hand in hand with the plan, hand in hand with the procedures and methods that the engineers would prefer to state, to suggest. Okay, so very important is a contractor. And because of that contractor, the area of project management becomes a professional area. It became an skill, an additional skill. Beforehand, there is no project management concept. And we demand a better performance from contractor. What do we mean by better performance from contractor? We need materials, we need equipment, we need device to certain time in the construction period, and we need those in time. For example, we need the crane, we need the mixer, we need those things at certain period of time. We don't need those equipments all the time because they pose obstruction, they pose danger, they pose risk, additional risk to the construction proper. So we just need them at certain period of time. So the contractor would be required to deliver those equipment, to deliver how many numbers of workers, to deliver the competent drivers of the heavy equipment. Those things are easily analyzed, easily delivered by the contractor itself by using tools that are already defined and established as we know it today, which is called project management. So let us go further. So there are following characteristic of any construction projects. So we can have the goal, objective of the project. So for example, we need to, we are asked by the owner to make a building for the mall. So that is the objective, completion of the mall building. For example, three-story mall building. Okay? A specific task not routinely performed. So number two, this is pertaining to the not the whole objective of building a mall, but cutting down those objectives, those bigger objectives into a smaller one, like what? Specific task like cleaning the ground. Cleaning the ground, preparing the soil, preparation of the soil, putting up the footings. So those are small tasks that must be made. And those are sometimes routine and sometimes not routinely performed because each and every building has different design. So meaning different distances of columns, different columns dimension, different flooring, different shape. So that's why in actual construction work, they are not routinely performed. So number three, we have to define beginning and end of the project. So because the difference of beginning and end, this is the actual project. Okay, so at what state will the project start? And at what state will the project end? this should be defined. This should be agreed upon by the technical person, the owners, and so on. And number four, we have defined deliverables. So define deliverables, after defining the beginning and end, the definition of ending, construction status, we should describe it in certain specific variables, in specific parameters. For example, one specific parameter is the building should be painted, okay? Outside and inside of the building should be painted. So that is a defined deliverable. For example, the flooring should be tiles, completely tiled. Because making of the building, tiles is not necessary, or painting is not necessary. Okay? However, it could be defined as the endpoint of our deliverables so that the owner could willingly accept with a graceful, accepting hands. Okay? So, and lastly, we have supposed to have resources being consumed. So there are resources, just like mentioned, raw materials, we have equipment. Equipment is being consumed, small portion of it at a time. For example, crane. It is not being consumed, one whole crane in one construction project. However, the value of the crane depreciates per project. For example, the crane is supposed to work for us for 30 years. The life cycle of a crane is for 30 years. So therefore, if one project is 5 years, then obviously the life expectancy of the crane decreased by 5 years. So therefore, the value of the crane is now less than 5 years. Okay? So those are the things that we have to appreciate in a certain project. Okay. So next is to build the project on time is also very important, particularly to the owner, because the owner building a mall would incur several losses without opening his mall to the public. Incur so much losses. For example, the target time is February 20, and the project is delayed by 20 days, another 20 days, so it will open March. So the loss of income that the owner will suffer upon is a big concern, so that the building of a project must be have a time element on it. Time is a very important criteria in a project construction, in a project management. Okay. Another one is the cost. Okay, so of course, the owner would like the cost to be lower as much as possible, and we as an engineer learning this and accepting the project, giving the guidance to the contractor, would like to guide the contractor to do not depreciate the quality of material, and also we would like the cost to be lower, but without having the quality going down. And since the contractor do not have those motivation in mind, we, the technical person, the engineers, part of our job is to make sure, to monitor that the quality, the minimum quality should be retained. Okay? Minimum design quality should be there during the construction of the project. So we have several steps of doing that. Number one, establish project plan, objective, so we can create those things. And the next one is to do research into materials and design. In the, this case, we are very much concerned about time and cost. Okay? And number three, design, estimate, and schedule. So we now have an scheduling of the project. Different phases of the project must be scheduled because there are project phases that cannot be done without another project phase completed. So there is some sense of sequential process that must take before some process will take place. So number four is present design to owner. Present design to owner, meaning after we plan the design, estimate, and schedule, let us orient the owner. Oh, this will be done, this will be done at certain period of time. It has a very important practical relevance to the owner because the owner will know at which time he could monitor something being delivered, being done in the construction area. Okay, expectation of the owner is important because he could check, and because of that, we can build the owner at certain period of time that, Mr. Owner, we now have to produce 3 columns out of 6 tomorrow, so please give us the budget for that. Okay, so it's very relevant, the scheduling, the estimate, the cost, because the owner would provide the money to carry out those buying of raw materials, sourcing of equipment, preparation of the site. Okay, so those things must be oriented to the owner. Then next is to analyze the project for viability. So with the other key players, contractor, engineers, architects, different types of engineers should be there. Civil engineer, mechanical engineer, electrical engineer, plumbing engineer should be there. And talk about in a meeting and analyze in group, by the group, so that the brainstorming should lead to more and more efficient final scheduling of the project. Okay? And then lastly, adjust project plans as needed, because after you analyze, you have a group brainstorming, then present an adjusted and selected course of action from different possibilities, from different choices. So we have to select one. Of course, you can have 1, 2, 3 for your plan A, plan B, plan C. Okay? However, you need to select what is plan A, what is plan B, what is plan C. You can do that now and go back to the beginning, because this procedure is a cycle, and also establish again the number one, the number two, number three, and number four, which is very much relevant, including the owner in the communication process, so that it is always oriented about what is happening on the ground. Okay? So this talk is actually about beginning, during, and just before the completion of the project. This cycle continues. Okay. As the project progresses, more and more information is known and needs to be considered. And it is very good if early decisions provide significant benefits. So that's why we are doing this cyclically, periodically. Okay? So that we can adjust properly in time before anything could happen. Okay? We can what? Not only the project procedure, process is efficient, also we can what? We can prevent, we can avoid emergency, we can avoid what? Accident. Okay? Take note, accident could happen, a small accident could happen that could potentially result in death, not only property losses, but in death or safety risk or welfare of the workers and nearby persons. So those are the things that benefits on this early decision making. This ability to influence project cost is also of utmost importance. Okay, construction project categories. So there are several construction works, and these are the basic categories. Number one, very much plentiful residential projects. So most of our project is focused on residential. It is expected because there are more residential buildings than commercial or industrial. Okay, like what? Condos, townhouse, apartments, single family homes. Owners may be development companies or developers. Okay, another category is building construction project, commercial, institutional, for example, like our university. This is an institution with building, and currently we are undergoing project construction of a new building there. So office building, large apartment building, shopping malls, theaters, these are institutional buildings, commercial buildings, and so on. It depends on economy, and therefore have slightly different characteristic than residential. So the type of discussion, the type of negotiation, the type of construction, a little bit different from residential. Okay. Okay. Uh-huh. What happened? Okay, so next is about heavy construction. So we have heavy construction, which includes roads. These are the facilities, more on public facilities, bridges. Those are public facilities, infrastructure, works being done by our government, by the public and local governments, like dams, tunnels, water systems, designed also by engineers, usually public projects. Also, the next one, the fourth one, is industrial project. So it may include the steel mills, petroleum refineries, chemical processing plants, production lines. Specialized design and construction is required in this line of project because, for example, automobile production line, chemical refractory plant. So there are extra effort, there are extra specialization that is needed in order to complete the project. So, for example, nuclear power plant, it also requires mechanical engineer together with civil engineer to construct what? The walls of the nuclear power plant. Unlike in residential, we don't need mechanical engineer to construct the wall. We just need civil engineer to construct the wall. Okay? Or even just a foreman could be able to construct a wall. However, in nuclear power plant, we need the inclusion of mechanical engineer just to construct a wall. Okay? So specialized field of study, not a general mechanical engineer, a mechanical engineer that is experienced in constructing nuclear plants, okay? Or similar structure. Okay? So those are the things. What happened? It is not next slide. Okay, we are waiting for the next slide. So, okay, another one. So, next. Yeah. Okay. So let us go to the next topic. How does the planning of the complete building, for example, works? What are the steps needed? So very much on the ground up. Not really, not just from the ground up, but before anything would be touched by the technical person, we need, number one, conceptual planning. What do we mean by conceptual planning? Concept, idea, creation of idea. We need to create idea which is being guided by the requirements being asked by the owner. For example, the mall being conceptualized requires 4 floors and, for example, 300 small cubicles for small businesses. Okay, so those are the things that we need to conceptualize. How many? Is it 300? Is not okay to have 250 cubicles? Oh. So those are during conceptual planning. Is it necessary for us to do it in 4 floors? How about 2 floors? Is that okay or? Not. Okay, so those are the things that we can talk about during conceptual planning. How about the general perspective of the building facade? How should it look like? The general design, the general shape, how it would look like? Because some commercial building, like in the first world countries, they have buildings that look like rocket ships. They have buildings that look like hamburger. There are buildings that look like bicycle or car. There are buildings that look like trains. So general perspective of the facade, the building, how it look like. Conceptual planning, okay? So we need to discuss that. The owner makes almost all the requirements, decisions that designers and engineers should solve. This is where the engineering problem solving appear. How to solve the requirement of the owner. Okay? And project cost and schedules. Okay? Iterative process. So actually, to give you an estimate, this conceptual planning sometimes could require more or longer period of time than the actual construction. For example, I myself, I have a project to build a robot. When I am working in Japan, I build a project, a single robot to be able to used in a company robotic application in production line. Okay, one robot. It took me 8 months to do the conceptual planning But it just took me 1 month to personally, I made the robot myself. All the connections, the mechanical part, the buying of raw materials, the scheduling of equipment to facilitate the development of the robot. I did it all myself. The motherboard used in controlling the robot, the electronics devices that must be connected, one IC to another, to the microprocessor, connecting it by wires, small wires. That is about, 25 years to 30 years ago. Today, it is a very simple matter to do that because we already have assembly of motherboard. You can just buy a motherboard and assemble it. However, during my time, when I am working in Japan, it is not that way. You have to do your own motherboard. You have to do all your own wiring of electronic parts. You have to do everything by yourself. Okay. And that would take you to a period of conceptual planning that is longer than the real construction of the robot. I was able to machine, the lathe machine, using milling machine, all the parts of the robot in 1 month. And test another month, testing, and then install in 2 weeks. So about less than 1 year, almost 1 year. It cost me almost 1 year to make a single project, but the project only have one engineer and one worker. Ako lang mag-isa, okay? I'm the only one working on it. So, however, in, for example, building, it cannot be done by a single person. It have to be done by several engineers, by several workers. That's why the length of time is now shortened. In addition, we have an advanced technology or like this one. We have advanced technology in computer design and so on. Every aspect of our technology is being utilized in construction. So the length is now shortened. However, still there is sufficient time required for conceptual planning. Okay? So next is, after planning it conceptually, you have to draw a sketch. You have to draw the sketch, not the AutoCAD ones. You don't need to finalize, just the sketch, pencil, ball pen, sketching on the paper. Okay? That is now part of actual schematic design. You are now starting to do your schematic design. Okay? And part and parcel of actual design process. Looking at methods and materials to use, you are now considering, if I use this material, the construction would be longer. If I use another type of material, the construction would be shorter. If I use this material, I need a high level of skill to do it. There might be a problem later on to hire somebody with that sufficient skill. There might be a problem that during the construction, I may not be able to hire somebody who could do it. So I may need alternative material so that less and less skill are necessary to do certain kind of work. Okay? Value engineering. So value engineering meaning you are putting so much technology, so much skill to the construction of certain project, and it adds up to the value of the project. It is easier here to express it this way. If you are going to build a robot and there are two people who will do it, one is an amateur and one is a professional, expect certain difference that will come up with the result. Expect somebody which is a very experienced professional to have a better quality than the one who is an amateur. Okay? And the difference between the two is what we call value. That is the value, an added value, just because we hired a professional, not the amateur. Okay? So, and that is why we need value engineering. We should value use of proper technology, use of proper equipment, use of proper skills, use of proper person to do the job. Okay? Those are the inputs to our value engineering. Imagine if your concrete laborer is a first timer to do what? Walling using the blocks or bricks. Okay? And imagine somebody is professional, 20 years of experience doing that same job. You can expect there are several what? Delay of the project if you use the beginners. Maybe you can use beginners as a helper to help the professional workers, okay? And there is some advantages and disadvantages to that, okay? This is part of what? Knowing it, because there are certain points in the schematic diagram that you need a specific line of work. The long lead time items. Okay, so proper sequencing of job is also understandably important, and you can do it by looking at the schematic diagram. Okay, so you can get the idea from that schematics which one is supposed to be done first, which one is supposed to be done next, and so on. Okay, so then next one is the preliminary estimate and schedule. So next process, development stage. This is the design stage where you are now what? For example, I am the general contractor. I would now include the other specialty engineers, okay, in finalizing the design phase. Okay? Okay? Make system choices based on cost and schedule. So we can do that because they are now being seen, talked, discussed, and analyzed by specialty engineers. Okay? And now we are now ready to have a pre-qualification process for bidders. So because we are now at have a list of course of action, project list of events, project list of activities. Okay, so we can now start with process for bidding. And then contract documents can now be finalized from considering the final design and determine work packages, electrical works packages, mechanical work packages, for example, aircon work packages, plumbing work packages, fire protection engineering work packages. Okay, so those are the type of packages that we are talking about here. Fair cost estimate and schedule developed. Now, those specialists, those bidding those consideration are now can be collected and have an estimation, no? Then construction, actual construction. So what are those in the real thing? Mobilization of equipment, mobilization of workers, mobilization of specialists. Okay, so what we mean? Milestones, meaning after mobilizing those equipment and workers at a specific instant of time, different group of workers will come in at different instant of time. We don't need an electrical project package at the start of the, we may need it after several weeks or several months for wrapping in. We just need it for wrapping in, the mechanical, we just need for wrapping in. So they are they will enter at a specific point in time. And after which, after they did their job, then again, another course of event happens, and we may need, for example, installation of now air conditioning, okay? Installation of powerful equipments like pumps, for example, okay? So those are the types of milestones that we are considering during the construction, okay? Substantial completion. We also have those, more probably to report good news to the owner, to report good news to the contractor, and to bill the owner for some additional budget, okay? Or some additional payment, okay? For example, progress billing, if the construction work is 50% finished, you can bill the owner by 50 or 60% so that you have additional money to roll for raw materials and money for what? Daily wage of workers. Okay? Substantial completion. Punch list. You are now considering and nearing the end game of the construction process. That's why you are now taking note of all important details, what happened, what really transpired. For example, electrical project package, what they did to the building, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You have to list down. They are standard punch list. Okay, you just have to check one by one if those are completed. Of course, the same is true with plumbing system, same is true with the mechanical punch list. So there are several, plentiful of punch list. Civil punch list, oh, of course, complete. Project closed out now, is in order. So you are finalizing because you already have so much punch list, and after which all of the punch list are checked. So you can now proceed to start the closing out of the project. Okay, what are the risks? There are several risks involved in any project. So let us go through it one by one. Bid depends on the amount of risk contractor is willing to take. Very important. There might be no bidders if there is too much risk involved. For example, during this pandemic, the risk for the contractor, because the contractors are required to test their workers almost daily, swab testing almost daily. And those swab testing is creating a risk for a contractor. It's okay if the testing is almost always negative. However, one or two persons contaminated with the virus, would tantamount to a very big problem for a contractor. Okay? The contractor will be hand-tied in several activities. For example, if the one having the positive testing is the crane operator, who will now operate the crane? And then therefore, you will have to what? To recruit another crane operator, and it will take time. It will take 3 days or 1 week, and then the construction process will stop on that piece of, on that portion that would require crane operation. So it is very much on the contractor. That is what was transpired during the pandemic, still now. The project contractor is being required to do it. And the contractors now unwilling, more and more they are unwilling to do it, and staying away from bidding, staying away from the projects, and what will happen? The economy will suffer. The economy will suffer because they are not willing to take the risk. Another type of risk is in the project site. During the project, process risk and the owner's organization. Those are so much risk. For example, project site. You have neighbors that are very difficult to communicate with. For example, you need access to some area, and you have to negotiate with your neighbor, and your neighbor is so much difficult to deal with, won't communicate, okay, will turn down all the communication. How will you do it? You will have alternative way, and that is a risk. For example, with a good neighbor, you can do a certain phase of work in 3 months, and with the village neighbor, you may take 3 months into up to 6 months or 1 year. So by what? Utilizing an alternative way of doing things. So it's risky because every day the laborers, the engineers have to be paid the wage. Even if they are not working, you have to pay. So those are the contractors' risk. Okay? So you need somewhat contingency. And because of higher risk, higher contingency measure should be applied. And will what? Will redound back to the budget of the project. Will add up the amount. The risk amount will add up to the project because of that. And we are now going to the how we could what? We could communicate to the different key players how much project cost, and how, in what way will the contractor is paid, and how it is being paid legally. So there are several types legally. These types are written down on the, for example, architectural ethics and professional code, engineers professional code. They are written down how we could what estimate the cost of the whole project. It involves our what? Our income. It involves our what? Our profit. So there is already what? Profit involved here. So number one, you can talk about fixed price. Okay. Meaning the project, I am going to do a mall. I have a budget, 5 million. So please do it. lump sum, 5 million, okay? So, fixed price. However, to give you an actual amount, 5 million is not worth, is not the amount of mall. $5 million, okay? 5 million pesos, you will have what? One small residential house nowadays, okay? So, for example, $5 million, so that is about 250 million. That is a small mall. That is a very small mall, okay? So, fixed price, or sometimes unit price, meaning, for example, the payment is unit price in terms of square meter. You have a vacant lot that you want a mall to be built with, and your vacant lot is 1,500 square meters. Oh. What is the amount per square meter? For example, 30,000 per square meter. Oh. So therefore, 30,000 per square meter, so the total amount therefore is 45 million, okay? In one floor. So if you are doing four floors, that is 45 million times four, and therefore that is about 180 million. So that is a small, that is a very small mall, okay? Okay? That is a small supermarket or market, okay? Unit price method. So these are the method for which we can talk to the contractor, to the engineers, the costing. Another method is cost plus fee. You have a fixed cost plus additional fee for the professionals, including architect, engineers, and so on. So it's another acceptable way of dealing with the contractor. Okay? Another way is GMP. Okay? So these are so we are through with the topic. I think that is the last slide. So thank you very much. And this is again Dr. Paulo Zantua, your summary engineer at your service.